Number 1. Turbulent Displace. Add this directly onto your text layer, head over to the effect controls and change the amount to 15 and the size to 25. Right now there is no movement, it's completely static, so we need to animate this by clicking on the stopwatch for the evolution at the very start, and now head to your last frame. Increase this to a very high amount. Something as high as 3 times 50 seems to work best, but if your layer is much longer than mine, mine's only about 1 second long. If it's 2 seconds, then you might have to double it, so just keep on increasing it until you are happy with the result. So this is what it looks like for me. Search for the posterized time effect, which is underneath time, so add that onto your text layer. And you want to decrease the frame rate to around 12. If your sequence is at 30 or 60, then you want to go for something like 15 instead. And this is going to create a choppy effect on your text. Now finally, you just want to change the quality from low to high. Number 2 is a static glitch effect. So for this one, you want to search for wave warp. This one underneath distort, add it onto your text layer. Wave type should be smooth noise. Leave the height at 10. Change the width to 120. Quality should be high, just like before. And most importantly, the direction. Right now it's at 90 degrees, which is left and right. You want to change that to 0. If you think that's too fast, you can change the speed to something lower. However, I'm going to add on posterized time again and increase it to something like 18. And that's going to maintain the speed but make it look a little bit choppy. However, if I do decrease the speed, let's go 0.5. This is what it looks like. The next one is a simple warp-like effect. And well, this does use the wave warp effect, so it kind of makes sense. So add that onto your text layer, head back into effects controls. Wave type should be smooth noise. Leave the height at 10, but change the width to 500. Leave the direction as it is, but the speed, because at the moment it's a bit too quick, right? So you want to change this to 0.1. Quality high. Now let's play it back. This is the result. Number 4 is a text glow effect. You want to add the drop shadow effect, which is underneath perspective, so add that onto your layer. Change the shadow color from black to white and click OK. Decrease the distance all the way to 0 and increase the softness from 0 to 10. You want to select the effect, Control C or just right click, copy, and Control V, which will paste it, or you can just right click, paste, and it's going to place another one on top. You want to increase this softness from 10 to 50. So we've got 10, 50. Let's paste on another one. Change this one to 100. Paste another one. Change this one to 500. Paste one last time, and it should be 2000. Or if you would like to, you can go for 1000 instead of 2000, and it looks like this. If you want to change the color, search for the tint effect, which is underneath color correction. So add that onto your text layer, and what you want to do is change the map white to a color of your choice. So let's go for like a greenish yellow. Let's just go for this color here. I'm going to select OK, and there you go. If you want to save it as a preset, then follow me. First of all, we're going to collapse all of these effects, so collapse by clicking on the arrows next to them. Starting from the very bottom, you want to hold shift on your keyboard and just left click. Whilst holding shift, you want to click on the tint. So that's going to highlight all of your effects. Right click, save preset, give it a name and click OK. And then all you need to do is just head over to your effects panel and search for that preset, and it should apply every effect that we just made. And the very final one is a hue color change. Now, first of all, you want to change the color of your text. So you pick any color. I've gone for a red. Search for HLS, which is color balance, HLS. So add this one onto your text. And you want to set a keyframe for the hue at the beginning. Head to the last frame and increase it to a value that works. So if I just keep on going 1 times 50, let's see how that looks. Okay, not too bad. If I want to speed it up even more, then I can just increase the value at the end. So now that I've doubled it, this is the result. And of course, if you want to make it slower, decrease it. So let's go for something really low, like 74, and you get a slow color changing effect. Let me know in the comments below if you know any other cool text effects. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Peace.